Welcome everyone. In this session, we will discuss how Microsoft Graph Toolkit accelerates app development. My name is Ayca Bash and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. Today for this session, my colleague Beth is joining us. Hi Beth, how are you doing?
Hello, I'm doing good. My name is Beth. I am a software engineer working for this organization that we handle first party and third party developer ecosystems and trying to unblock devs to build on top of Microsoft platform services and technology. And one of them right now is Microsoft Graph. And so our team manages the toolkit for Microsoft Graph.
As you know, I'm a big fan of Microsoft Graph Toolkit. Our teams work together to build this awesome module, Get Started with Microsoft Graph Toolkit at Microsoft Learn. Beth, since you're a part of Microsoft Graph Toolkit product team, why don't you tell us the story of Graph Toolkit and what it is?
Sure. So at the beginning, when we were first given the task of figure out how to help developers to build on top of the graph, we actually went out and interviewed a lot of our customers, both our first-party partners or, you know, third-party communities. And one of the most mentioned pain points that we heard was authentication and authorization with the graph is really difficult. So our team decided, you know, what if we just built a component that's fully functional behind the scenes, and you just need to drop it somewhere in your HTML page and it just works. So that's when we have the MTT login component. And from there on, we just kind of built more components that follows the same practice and you can drop them on your HTML page and it just works.
Wow, that's so cool. And I actually love using Microsoft Graph Toolkit components and providers because they're super easy to consume in our apps.
Right, so these are pre-built UI and authentication providers that help you, you know, really cut the development time. And because they're fully functional behind the scenes, you don't really have to write a lot of sort of plumbing code, right? So as soon as you add the proper authentication provider and then you drop, you know, some HTML tags on your page, it cuts the development times by a lot.
Yeah, and also Graph Toolkit has a great selection of supported platforms and the frameworks. That's awesome.
Right. So when we first designed Microsoft Graph Toolkit, we really wanted to work everywhere, which is why we chose to use web components. These are components that built on web standards. So it works with any web frameworks that you can think of, Angular, React. We even have a React wrapper to help you build functional React components. It's called MGT-React. And because they're all web standards, it works for or in all the web browsers.
Okay, so all of these are really cool. And I know that components have pre-built UI that looks and feels like Microsoft Graph experience in default out of the box. What about developers who wants to customize the look and fit their styling with their components?
Right. You can, of course, you can use, you know, templates or CSS custom properties to tweak the look and feel of your components. And we also have theming system that you can theme all your components all together, and including dark theme, because, you know, all the devs love dark theme.
Yeah, I'm sure lots of developers will look for a dark theme. So I'm glad we have that in Microsoft Graph Toolkit. Cool. So let's check out what is in Microsoft Graph Toolkit.
We have a lot of components, like I said. Login was the first one, and then we decided to build more to fit different needs. And a good place to explore and play around with these is called Microsoft Graph Toolkit Playground.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's a really nice place to practice about Microsoft Graph Toolkit. Let me quickly walk you through what is Microsoft Graph Toolkit Playground and where you can find it. First of all, if you go to mgt.dev, you will be directed to the Playground. And this tool is super easy to use, to be honest. On the left side, you see all the components listed. And on the right side, you have the component itself. If you customize anything here under the canvas, you will see the changes automatically. For example, you're under Microsoft Graph Toolkit agenda component. Now, if I add or customize anything about the agenda component, it should appear under the canvas. Let's, for example, group events by day. And the moment I add group by day, it will automatically group events under the related day. So that's super cool. So definitely this is a really nice place to practice about Microsoft Graph Toolkit. And this exists for all the components. Let's try to check out other ones like MGT people. Again, this already has some attributes like show max. And whenever you change anything, you will see the changes under the canvas.
Right. So these are good attributes and properties that you can use to tweak what you want the functionality to look like or what your UI components to look like. And there's a lot of these attributes and properties available. A good place to explore these attributes and properties, if you're already in the playground, you can click on the Docs tab right next to Canvas, and you will see, you know, the list of attributes that you can use in your HTML tags or properties that you can use behind the scenes with your JavaScript. Or the events that these components fires and CSS custom properties that's available for you to change styling. Another good place to look at these is if you go to aka.ms/mgt-docs. So that's where the official documentation for Microsoft Graph Toolkit lives. And there's also, you know, a lot of good getting started guides for different platforms. And like we said, the with different authentication providers as well.
Yes, so official documentation has a lot of good information. So if you want to have deep dive information, you can check out this doc. And if you want to stick in the playground and explore practice a little bit, you can also check out docs for each and every component.
Exactly.
Okay, so let's see what else we have in Microsoft Graph Toolkit.
The second part, which is also, in my opinion, some of the most important things in the Graph Toolkit, are the authentication providers and helpers that really just makes it super easy to connect to the graph, right? So out of the box, you have the MSAR provider, which will, you know, get the token and call the graph, and then in exchange for information and represent it in your application. But outside of building web apps using MSAR provider, you can also enable your application to be as part of SharePoint platform. For example, if you're building SharePoint web parts, or if you're building, you know, Teams platform apps such as Teams tab apps, to convert your web apps into these platforms, you can use our SharePoint authentication provider or Teams auth provider. And on top of all of these, recently we just created the Electron provider to help people build cross-platform applications if you wanted to enable some of the native capabilities, such as, you know, Windows notifications or changing image in your background, the desktop background, such, you know. So fun things like that. And we also have two more at the bottom, proxy and custom, are kind of enable people who already have your own ways of handling the authentication behind the scenes. And you can just enable a proxy provider or custom, build your own custom provider in order to use the Microsoft Graph Toolkit.
Awesome. So with all these components and providers, we actually have a lot of different things we can do.
So there are a lot of different types of apps that you can build with all these authentication providers. And we already kind of touched on, you know, web apps and with any frameworks. And you can also translate your web app into a Microsoft Teams app and SharePoint web part using different auth providers that come out of the box. Electron apps is a kind of a fun one that we're starting to explore. And we would love to hear more from the community on how you're using it. What are the things that you're seeing with it? And the last one is kind of in the middle. We wanted to enable our developers to export their web apps into PWAs in order to, you know, utilize things such as the Microsoft Store that you can, you know, utilize the infrastructure in the store in order to distribute your app as well. And we have great tools for, like, Microsoft itself has great tools such as the PW Builder once you're done with your web app.
That's cool. So should we go ahead and try how these components and providers work in a real app?
Yes, after all this talking, let's get to the action.
Let's do it. So I already created a folder and index.html here in Visual Studio Code what we're going to do is we will have a very general HTML piece, and we will add first Microsoft Graph Toolkit loader to have all the goodies from MGT providers and the components. Then we will use MSAL provider as one of the providers Beth mentioned earlier. And the last step, we will add our components, like login component and all the other fancy components. So let's start. I will click Control Space and add HTML sample. And inside the body, I will just have Microsoft Graph Toolkit loader. I have it in here. Let me just quickly get the script and paste it in here. So this MGT loader will bring me all the providers and components. The second step is just using MSAL provider. And here we need client ID. Beth, would you like to explain why do we need client ID in this case?
Right, so your app is going to need to talk to the Microsoft Identity Platform for getting the token and how to, you know, obtain information from there on, right? So it needs like an entry space per se. So the client ID will know which app that's registered with the all the configuration that comes with it in Azure portal. So we're probably gonna do that right here in a little bit.
Yeah, exactly. We will do that piece too. Before we just get our client ID from Active Directory, let's add our very popular component, MGT login. So before just creating Azure Active Directory app, let's try to check out what's happening in our app. I'll open my palette and run the live server. Now our app is running localhost 3000. Let's quickly go to localhost 3000 in our browser. Let me grab the browser. There we go. So now we have our sign-in button, but it's not working yet. Since we don't have the client ID in our code, it is just showing us a pretty looking UI, but the authentication piece is not working. As Beth mentioned earlier, let's try to go to Azure Active Directory and register an app in Active Directory, get our client ID and see what happens. I will go to portal.azure.com. Let's make this bigger. Now I'll scroll down and choose Azure Active Directory. In Azure Active Directory, I'll find app registrations. And then I will click new registration. There we go. So now this is the place we're going to register a new application, and we will use the client ID. Let me give this a name, MGT Learn Together -demo. And our second step is just defining what kind of accounts can reach out to our app. Beth, would you like to explain what are these? Why do we use these at all?
Right. So there's a couple tenant types. The first one for single tenant, that just means whatever account that you're using to create the app registration, the app can only be installed in the current tenant, which if you see the right upper corner, the admin account belongs to Contoso, so that's why it says Contoso only. Or you can build an app and try to install it and support an enterprise scenarios for multi-tenant, which is why the second option says multi-tenant. That means that you can install this app outside of the current tenant as well. And the third one supports not only multi-tenant consumer scenarios, you can also commercial scenarios. You can also support consumer scenarios using personal accounts such as your .live.hotmail.com. And the last one is just if you want to support only a personal account, that's what you select. I think for the demo purpose, let's select the third one, which supports all of the, because we want to distribute our app to everybody possible.
Yeah, so let's make our app for everyone. Everyone can use our app. For the redirect URI is the last piece for registration of an app. And this redirect URI we are using after the authentication, this is going to be the place our app will continue going. For us, our app is running in localhost 3000, so we wanted to get back localhost 3000 when the authentication piece is done. Then I'm going to type localhost 3000 and we're good to go. I will register this app. Okay, so once the registration is done, we have one last step to complete. Under the authentication, we have to enable implicit grant.
Right, these are tokens that will enable MGT to know, you know, what with the permission scope, what kind of data that it needs to retrieve from Microsoft Graph.
Yeah, so that's why we just check access tokens and ID tokens. I will save this. And we are done. Let's go to overview, grab our client ID, and let's get back to our code. I will paste our client ID here, save it, and then let's check our app. Here, now I will click the sign in button, and there we go. We have a proper authentication. I will choose my account. It's asking me some permissions, like read your profile. That means after the authentication, it will show me my username, email address, my picture, and so on. I will consent this and accept. Wow, there we go.
Ta-da!
So this is really magic because we literally added 3 lines of HTML code and we have a good looking UI with my picture and username and email address. This is really awesome and pretty useful and pretty practical as well. Let's try to test some of the other components in our HTML. What else we should add, Beth? What do you think?
Let's get the person's agenda items so that I don't have to go out to my email to check my calendar every day.
Okay, let's add MGT agenda. I added MGT agenda. We get back to our app. Oh, now it's asking more permissions like calendars. Okay.
Right. So this is incremental consent. Every time something more from MGT is added to the page, it'll auto detect what are the scopes that is needed and then try to get that for you.
This is awesome. With 4 lines of code, we have the sign in and the authentication. We have the user profile as well as now we can see user's calendar. This is really awesome. And it looks pretty good as well in the UI perspective.
Exactly.
Wow, that's cool. So let's check out where can learners find out these kind of practical things and where they can learn more about Microsoft Graph Toolkit and maybe build something like this, what we did in demo.
Yes.
So we recently built a great module in Microsoft Learn. If you go to ak.ms/learn-mgt, you will be directed to get started with Microsoft Graph Toolkit. This module will walk you through what is Microsoft Graph Toolkit, and it will also have some practice materials. You will practice and build an application like just we did in the demo piece, and you will discover Microsoft Graph Toolkit a little bit more.
That's awesome. I already started mine.
Yeah, that's cool. So this is all from us. Thank you everyone for joining our session. I hope you enjoy the rest of the sessions as well. So back to the studio.